Okay, today we are going to discuss about one of the important topic of 11th science, that is redox reactions. Okay, redox reaction is nothing but the combination of reduction and oxidation. Now, if you discuss about the redox reaction, it's a two reaction simultaneous taking place as reduction as well as oxidation. Hence, we call is redox reaction. In short, the simultaneous oxidation reduction taking place is called as redox reaction. Now we'll see what is reduction and what is oxidation. According to the classical definition, we can define in different ways of oxidation and reduction. Now, oxidation reaction. Now, according to the chemical reaction, here the first way to define oxidation is, that is addition of oxygen. In any species, if oxygen gets added, it is called as oxidation. Like we undergo respiration process, in that case we take oxygen, that means it's oxidation. Similarly, if you burn the paper or burn the wood or burn the fuel, is also called oxidation. We'll take the example, that is addition of oxygen. Carbon solid undergo oxidation, that is it burns in presence of oxygen, it changes to carbon dioxide. Similarly, taking the metal magnesium, burn in presence of oxygen, that undergo addition of oxygen called oxidation. So addition of oxygen is oxidation. Another example, that is addition of electronegative element. So another definition of oxidation is, if you add the electronegative element to the species, also called as oxidation. For example, zinc reacts with chlorine. This chlorine is electronegative element, it gets added to the zinc, it changes to formation of zinc chloride. So it is called as oxidation. Another classical definition of oxidation is removal of hydrogen. So removal of hydrogen from the species or substance, also known as oxidation. For example, hydrogen sulfide reacts with bromine. In this case, here hydrogen gas, hydrogen gets removed with the help of bromine, and will get the formation of HBr plus sulfur. Here the hydrogen gas removed, or hydrogen is removed, that is also called as oxidation. Another classical definition, that is removal of electropositive element. So to remove electropositive element is also called as oxidation. We'll take the example as potassium iodide treated with chlorine. Now here potassium is electropositive, so removing the potassium from potassium iodide, it changes to formation of potassium chloride and will get the iodine. So in this case, the removal of electropositive, also called as oxidation reaction. So these are the classical definition of oxidation. Now we'll move to the classical definition of reduction. If you remember, the addition of oxygen is oxidation. It's a reverse or opposite in case of reduction. So we'll see. Reduction reaction. Now the classical definition of reduction is addition of hydrogen. So we'll take the example of addition of hydrogen, that is zinc oxide treated with hydrogen gas, will get the formation of zinc and H2O. Here this hydrogen gas get added into zinc oxide. Zinc oxide given out the oxygen and combined with the hydrogen form H2O. This is also called as reduction, as addition of hydrogen. Another definition of reduction, that is addition of electropositive element to the species. If electropositive element is added to the species, then it is also called as the reduction. Now we'll see the example of sodium reacts with sulfur. In this case, the electropositive element is sodium, which is get added to the sulfur. It change into formation of sodium sulfide. This is also called as addition of electropositive, called reduction reaction. Now another, next is removal of oxygen. Removal of oxygen also called as reduction reaction. For example, H2O is treated with sulfur. Now here the oxygen gets removed from the H2O and it will convert into H2S plus, will get half O2. Here oxygen is removed from the H2O. Another example, that is iron oxide treated with carbon. Carbon is a reducing agent which removes the oxygen. So here in this case, we'll get the formation of Fe and we'll get the formation of carbon dioxide. So we'll get here, that is a removal of oxygen from the species called iron oxide, is also known as reduction. Another classical definition is, that is removal of electronegative element from the species. Now we'll take the example of reduction, that is a removal of electronegative species. We'll take silicon dichloride, which is treated with the metal like potassium, or we can take silicon tetrachloride treated with potassium. Now in this case, the chlorine is electronegative. This chlorine will removed from silicon tetrachloride by potassium, so it will convert into Si plus, will get 4 potassium chloride. This also called as reduction. So friends, the oxidation is addition of oxygen and reduction is addition of hydrogen, or in other way we can have this summary of oxidation and reduction. And if both the reaction undergo simultaneous, the reaction is called as redox reaction. Now redox reaction can also be defined on the basis of electron transfer theory. So we'll move to the what is electron transfer theory. So we'll see that the redox reaction based on electron transfer theory, we'll see what is reduction on the basis of electron transfer theory. What is electron transfer theory? Electron transfer theory is nothing but the electron move from one species to the another species during chemical process. The reactant change to product, where in the reactant, if the electron transfer in the species and going to form the product where the electron get deposited into another species. So what is reduction? So first we'll see what is oxidation on the basis of electron transfer theory. Now oxidation is nothing but the loss of electron from the species. So any substance or any species during the chemical process, if it lost the electrons, then the reaction is called as oxidation reaction. For example, sodium atom changed to sodium ion. So we'll take that sodium ion. Now this change to the sodium ion by loss of one electron. Similarly, copper change to copper ion by loss of 2 electron, and so on. Aluminium change to aluminium ion by loss of electron. In this way, such reaction taking place in the chemical process, which is called as redox reaction, where oxidation taking place by loss of 1, 2, or 3, and so on, with respective sodium, copper, and aluminium. Here, the loss of one electron, also called oxidation, loss of 2 electron from the copper, also oxidation, and loss of 3 electron from aluminium, also called oxidation. Here, the sodium metal, though it is a electropositive, it lose one electron from outermost orbit, so it become sodium plus charge. Similarly, copper also lose 2 electrons from the outermost orbit. It lose 2 electron to form copper plus plus charge, And similarly, aluminium lose 3 electron, acquiring the plus 3 charge on it. Now, the oxidation is taking place on the same way. Simultaneously, reduction reaction also takes place in the chemical process. So, what is reduction reaction? Now, it's the opposite of it. The reduction reaction is nothing but the gain of electrons from the species. So, reduction is nothing but the reaction in which species gain the electrons. So, we'll take the example as chlorine gas. During the chemical process, 2-chlorine taking the 2 electrons, so we'll write here 2 electron is gained by chlorine, it become 2Cl minus. Here 2-chlorine, 1 each get 1 electron, it added, we say gain of electron, hence it's a reduction. So reduction of chlorine, that is the addition of electron. Another example, we'll take the oxygen. Now here, the one oxygen atom take 2 electron to form oxygen minus minus charge as an ionic form. So here each oxygen take 2 electron, so it also undergo reduction reaction and so on. So such reaction is oxidation reduction. If we take the example of redox reaction, it is very simple example as sodium plus chlorine. Here sodium solid form and chlorine in the gaseous state. So this reaction undergo formation of sodium chloride salt. Here look at sodium, as we observe here, it undergo oxidation. Look at sodium change to sodium ion. So here we'll take plus charge. Now sodium lose electron. So we'll write here oxidation reaction. We called half oxidation reaction. Why? Because it's a chemical process or chemical reaction is one. In this case, simultaneous reaction is taking place. So one side the sodium undergo oxidation and in the other way, that is chlorine undergo reduction by gain of electron, that is reduction, half reduction reaction. So at the same time, chlorine taking the electron and undergo reduction reaction, simultaneous reaction taking place. Number of electron loss is equal to number of electron gain. So it acquire the minus charge. So one plus charge and one minus charge, it balance the compound. The sum of oxidation number for both are same. So this is the redox reaction as far as the electron transfer theory is concerned. Now we'll look at this plus charge, what we call, or this minus charge, what we call. Now we'll move to the next part, that is oxidation number. Now this oxidation number is come from the reaction as oxidation and reduction. Okay, now oxidation number, or it also called as oxidation state. Both have the similarity but little difference between oxidation number and oxidation state. I will talk later about the little difference, what is it. Now what is oxidation number? Actually, oxidation number we abbreviate in terms of the number written on the symbol of the element. For example, if I have the sodium ion. So I will call the oxidation number of sodium is 1, that is plus 1. Similarly, copper. So oxidation number of copper is plus 2. Similarly, aluminium have 3 plus charge. So oxidation number is here 1, 2, 3. So similarly, we'll take the negative charge ion. Here chlorine ion have 1 minus. So oxidation number of chlorine is 1 minus and oxygen is 2 minus. So these are about oxidation number. Now what is the definition of oxidation number? So we'll write here as the definition of oxidation number, that is the number of electron or electrons loss or gain by any species, or species may be atom, ion or molecules. So the number of electron loss or gain by any species which acquire positive or negative charge. It acquire either positive or negative charge. It's actually the number, the oxidation number is nothing but it is a number which is written on the symbol of the element. So we can also call it is the number written on symbol of element. For example, if I have write here as the copper, if I write here plus plus, so its oxidation number, right here oxidation number is 2. If I write here O minus minus, the oxidation number is 2. Now only difference is here plus charge, here minus charge. Both have same oxidation number. Now we'll move to the what is the little difference between oxidation number and oxidation state. We'll see the definition of oxidation state. Now here oxidation state is nothing but it's a numerical charge. You have to underline it's a numerical charge written on symbol of element. Now here as mentioned here, another example take, that is the potassium. Here the symbol of element of potassium is K, and I have written the numerical charge. This is numerical charge plus 1. So this plus 1, the oxidation state is plus 1. So I'll write here oxidation state of potassium is plus 1. Another example is aluminium. Here I'll write here plus 3, so oxidation state is plus 3. Here the symbol of aluminium is Al and its charge is plus 3. Similarly, if I write here sulfur, if mention here minus 2, now look at the charge on the sulfur is minus 2, so numerical charge, that is we call oxidation state, is minus 2. Hence the oxidation state and oxidation number also mention on the group ions. Group ions also have the specific oxidation number or oxidation state. For example, we'll take the sulfate ion SO4 2 minus, hydroxide ion, carbonate ion and so on. Now it's a whole group sulfate whose oxidation state is minus 2. Here minus 2 charge is given. Now oxidation state of hydroxide is minus 1 and oxidation state of carbonate is minus 2. Why? Because here the charge is given on the group of ions, so oxidation state is given as such. Similarly, the positive charge group, here NH4 ammonium ion, whose oxidation state is plus 1. Why? Because of plus charge the whole group. So this is called as oxidation number and oxidation state. Now we'll go to the next part about the reaction involving the oxidation reduction where the species are taking part. We called as oxidizing agent and reducing agent. So we'll discuss, that is, what is oxidizing agent and what is reducing agent. Oxidizing agent, also called as oxidant, now this oxidizing agent is either molecule, ion or atom which take part in the chemical reaction and undergo the chemical process. Now what is the oxidizing agent? It is a substance, right here, a substance or a species which undergo itself reduction and which allow the species to undergo reduction, or it oxidizes the other species or molecule. So itself undergo reduction means oxidizing agent get reduced itself and oxidizes the other. Now we'll take the example how it get reduced and get oxidized to the other one. We'll take the example as the carbon monoxide. Now this carbon monoxide treated with, here we'll take Fe. Now here carbon monoxide is a oxidizing agent which oxidizes the Fe, so it will convert into Fe2O3, so and will get carbon reduced. Now take the balancing equation here, 2, or we'll write here 4, 2 and here 6, so it's balancing the equation. Now so carbon monoxide act as a oxidizing agent which oxidizes the ion, convert into iron oxide and become carbon. Another example, we'll take sodium plus, we'll take the chlorine gas. Now it will convert into formation of sodium chloride. So I'll write here NaCl. I will underline the oxidizing agent. Look at here. This chlorine is oxidizes the sodium, convert into sodium chloride. So chlorine act as a oxidizing agent. What is the characteristics of oxidizing agent? Number one, it get reduce itself. How we can understand it get reduce itself? Look at here. Here the oxygen attached to the carbon, so oxygen is removed, so it get under reduction. So it's get reduce itself, that it remove the oxygen from it. Second characteristic, look at the oxidation state. Now here oxidation state, as we learned before, now in case of chlorine molecule the oxidation state is zero. When it will convert into the compound form, the oxidation state is changed to, that is minus. That means the oxidation state is from zero to minus, it is reduction. So it get reduce itself, but it changing or it oxidizes to the other species. As in the first example, this Fe get oxidized. Look at here, the oxygen is added into Fe, so it get oxidizes. So these are the characteristic of oxidizing agent. It's also called as oxidant. Now we'll move to the next, reducing agent. Reducing agents also called as reductant. Now what is the definition? So we'll write as a substance which undergo itself oxidation and reduces the other species. Now here the reductant or reducing agent itself oxidize and it reduce the others. For example, now we'll take the same example or we'll take the another one to understand better way, that is here zinc plus Cl2, so it change to zinc chloride. Now here the reducing agent, here zinc in a free state, it's showing the oxidation state is zero, change to the plus two charge. Here the zinc get oxidizes, it undergo oxidation. As we know that the changing from zero to plus, it's a oxidation, so it undergo oxidation, it get oxidize, but it reduces the another species. Here it change to minus zero to minus one. As we discuss here, the chlorine which get reduced into chlorine minus, same case here, zinc reduces the chlorine minus zero to minus one, its oxidation state decreases. So we have to know the characteristics as the characteristics of oxidizing agent, same as opposite the characteristic of reducing agent. Number one, the reducing agent itself oxidize, and second, it reduces the other one. Remember one more character in the both the cases, that oxidizing agent itself changing the oxidation number from higher to the lower, and here in case of reducing agent the oxidation number changing from lower to the higher state. In short, in the redox reaction, these two species taking the oxidation and reduction reaction. Hence, the redox reaction, the reaction in which oxidation and reduction simultaneously taking place, is called as redox reaction, where the species are taking part in the chemical reaction is called oxidizing agent and reducing agent. It is